these kind of people, you kind of people, have become important to me in a way that I never would have thought I even needed before becoming a member of Mothers Out Front. Before I became a member of Mothers Out Front, I was kind of like the little kid, a little boy in a video that's been going around. I don't know if you guys have seen it, but his mom videotaped him sitting strapped in his booster seat in the back seat of the car. He's in tears, sobbing, because he's just learned about what's happening on the earth. He's only about 6 years old, and he's inconsolable. He's crying in pain and anger because he just found out what's happening, and he says to his mom, "Mom, they're wrecking the planet." I know how he feels. I guess you guys probably know how he feels too. For a long time, I felt helpless in the same way that that little boy feels helpless. But as a grown-up, instead of sobbing, I turned bitter. And except for making a few donations when I could, I remained completely ineffectual, helpless, and hopeless. And then in 2015, I heard that people were organizing a big march down in New York City to demonstrate their outrage about what's happening to the climate. And I went down to Manhattan to be a part of it. Maybe some of you were there. There was this moment in the march when at one signal, all 400,000 people fell absolutely silent in honor of the gravity of what's happening to the earth. And for one long, poignant moment, we just held hands and stayed still and looked at one another. And when the minute was over, the man in front of me, a stranger, turned around with tears in his eyes and he said, "I thought I was alone." We are not alone. They've compelled the powers that be to make real change. In the second week of this month, Portugal ran on renewable energy alone for 4 consecutive days.
Woo! Yeah!
And on May 15th, Germany powered almost all of its electricity needs with clean energy alone. And at times, the supply exceeded the demand. Will be commonplace in just a few years. The energy transition is gathering momentum. Today, right now, as we stand here, members and supporters of 17 different organizations fighting climate change are descending on Lower Manhattan to take a stand at the clean energy hearing, to demand that legislators put the power of the law behind Cuomo's clean energy standards. To buy from renewable energy resources, and we need to invest in those alternative sources to make that happen. It's possible. The most expansive project that's on the table is what Mary just told you about, the Long Island, New York City offshore wind project. If developed, it would be a 350 megawatt facility with the potential to expand to 700 megawatts. And as Mary was saying, even at only 40% of its capacity, it would generate enough power to power up 112,000 homes. This is the kind of infrastructure that's required to transition off fossil fuels and to stay climate change. And it's up to us to push it. And this is why Mothers Out Front has decided to make the Long Island, New York City offshore wind project our statewide campaign.
Yeah.
We're joining us. We're joining forces with the people downstate to make this project a flagship for the kind of transitions we want to see happen all over the state and then all across the country.
Yeah.
It's the kind of work that joins us to activists all around the world working to free us from fossil fuels. The kind of change that can help spark a renewable energy revolution. It's the kind of action that can bring hope and comfort to that little boy and to all of us. So, in that spirit and with that resolve, please join us now as we launch the Offshore Wind Project campaign! Thank you all so much. And now in solidarity of the folks down in Manhattan, we want to take a lot of pictures for the social media platform and say that we're doing it in Rochester. So we're going to get up here on the stairs and have somebody take pictures.